Hey guys, welcome back to some more Football Manager 2017 and the first part of Season 2 of Non-League to Legend with Gateshead. And today we have our first League 2 match against Leighton Orient, but for some reason they're called Orient on this game. I don't know whether that's just the real name fix that I've used, but I've noticed it about Accrington and Stanley. I thought Stanley had made it all the way up to League 2 and without me knowing. But before we get into things, let's have a look at our transfer business over the summer, which I'm fairly happy about. Just move that light because hopefully you can see it's a bit better now. So transfer history. Yeah, we've made quite a few signings, but a lot of people have gone. You know, the likes of Stitch, Kanda, Bouchan, Hogan, McDonald, Scott Johnson, Niall Bell, Fifield, Elfad Aliou and Coker, they're all gone. Matthew George has gone as well. On the ins, Scott Brown from Accrington Stanley for $4,500. He's quite good, 32 years old. He's been around the league system for years, so he knows what he's doing. He did drop down a couple of divisions, you know, a few years ago, and then got back with Accrington Stanley. But hopefully he'll do all right for us and be a bit of an experienced head in the middle of the park. We also signed this guy, Josh Coulson, on a free transfer, $4,000 compensation. Three-star current ability, three-star potential. He's 28 years old and you know, he's quite a good player. He did all right. He's done all right in a couple of seasons in League 2, and then last year didn't really play at all, so that's weird. Gary Deegan for $9,000 from Shrewsbury Town. yeah, three star. You know, a lot of average players I think I've brought in. Nobody particularly brilliant just yet. Jake Cassidy from Guiseley for free. This was a very good signing, even if I do say him so myself. 3.5-star current ability, 4.5-star potential. And he scored 15 goals in 34 starts last year with 3 assists as well. And he's had a very good pre-season, 4 goals in 2 starts. So, yeah, I'm very, very happy. Gideon Adu-Pepra has come in from Newcastle on loan. Christy Pym has come in for free. 22 years old. He's going to come in as our first choice goalkeeper. He's had an okay pre-season. But yeah, he's played in League 2 before. He knows what the league's like. Zane Francis Angle, probably signing of the summer. I don't know, you guys will have to let us know. But wing back left, we're obviously going to play him at left back. But he had a wonderful year in the National League North last year. Obviously he's going to step up 2 divisions now, so it's going to be interesting to see what he can do. But I had been trailing him for quite a while, and Kidderminster wanted a lot of money for him, so I'm hoping he's good. Another guy we've brought in is James Alibi for $49,500. Quite a lot, but he scored 27 goals last year in the conference with 4 assists. One annoying thing though is that he's just picked up an injury for 2-3 months, so he's not going to see the first half of the season. We've brought back Callum Williams, free transfer. He was released by Newcastle. I thought it's a no-brainer after the season he had. He's very, very good. And Adam Marriott, you might remember him from the last episode, the top goal scorer in the conference with 37 goals in 47 games. He's had a 41 goal season back then, went all the way at Stevenage and has scored goals at this level. Okay, not many, but he knows how to find the net, and that's what I like about him. So yeah, I'm quite happy with our transfer business. We've kept hold of our best players. Newcastle, we lost 4-2. That's not bad. Jake Cassidy with a couple of goals, which is why he's starting today. Looking at the squad, it's a decent size this year. Last year it was far too big. I've shifted all the deadwood down to here. Hoping to get rid of quite a few of them, to be honest with you. Right. With that being... why is he on reserve, Judy? He shouldn't be. Yeah, let's get rid of that. Right, so tactics then. Here we go. Looking at the team for today, we've got Christy Pym in goal. We've got Jared Hodgkiss, at right back. He's starting out instead of Perry Cotton, who had a pretty poor pre-season, so I've brought in Jared Hotchkiss instead. Williams and Smith starting an unchanged back line there, with Angol coming in as the left back. We've got Brundle, Mafuta and Brown in the middle, with Corey Francis in behind Jay Cassidy and Matt Godden. Decent bench. Wes York can only make the bench, as does Adam Marriott. So, you know, there's certainly some big players on the bench that we can bring on. But we're really hoping for a good performance today against Leighton Orient. I'm really looking forward to this. League 2, let's see how we can do. Let's prove a point. Come on. Come on, Gateshead. The board only want us to fight bravely against relegation, so they don't necessarily want us to avoid relegation. And the media predict us a 20th or 22nd place finish. Yeah, 22nd, so just avoiding relegation by the skin of our teeth. I'd settle for that, definitely. Consolidation this year. He has gone. Now Smith and Francis Cassidy and Francis Angol in the middle, and Cassidy sticks it in the back of the net. Jay Cassidy, the form man from pre-season, sticks it in the back of the net, and it's 1-0 against Leighton Orient. And what a return to the Football League for the first time in 60 years, I want to say, for Gateshead. So we've come back with a bang within the first 20 minutes. Francis Angol, the man that I marked out at the start, with the assist, and Jay Cassidy with the goal. Very, very good indeed. Now then, Nicky Maynard. I recognise that name. I do recognise that name. But there's half time and 1-0 up. I'm pretty happy about that, I'm not going to lie. Maynard, that's a good tackle. Sorry about getting all the episode numbers wrong last season as well. I kept saying part 8 for part 9, whatever. Because I've literally just uploaded them all today. Obviously, I'm well ahead. About a week ahead of episode 1 coming out. So, you can understand how far in advance this is. And look at how boring this match has been. Sorry, guys. Just the look of the draw, isn't it? But certainly a good start of the season. If we can hold on to this 1-0 victory, we'll bring on three new players. And that's it. 3-0, I wish. 1-0, 3 points, and we're off the mark. That's all we could have asked for, really. We've got Wigan in the EFL Cup first round, so we'll see how we do in that. But League 2 kicks off. Anything about us in there? Forest Green Rovers got absolutely hammered. Bless them. Coke has done all right for, is it Borehamwood that he's playing for? Yeah. And Francis Angol, the player of the match in his first outing. And I said he could be our signing of the summer. Let us know who you think is the signing of the summer down below in the comments. And when we're going to come back. Well, it'll be in September for the League 2 match against Oldham. We've got Wigan again in the Checker Trade Paint Trophy. But we're going to play Oldham in League 2. And hopefully you guys have enjoyed this episode. Please leave a like down below if you did. You don't have to, of course, but mean a lot for me and for the channel. And I hope you guys are having a wonderful day. Thanks for watching and goodbye.